terracotta building on the shore.
That shore. Sorry.
What did you think I was meaning?
No, I think you meant the North Shore.
Because there's a shore on both sides.
Yes.
This is the nature of your shore. These are all the parrot competition entries, and we'll tell you about those in a moment, but we're going to have a look at your feedback. Mm. Thank you for your feedback today. Mm. We'll just briefly have a look at it.
A little bit about the rugby here, because we did talk to our rugby correspondent this morning in Marseille, where the All Blacks are now. It's our national game, and we are all proud of it. Go the All Blacks, bring back the World Cup home where it belongs. New Zealand's sheep-like obsession with rugby sickens me.
Ooh, harsh words.
Are we a country obsessed with rugby, or does the media show us nothing else? Well, I think most people are quite interested, aren't they?
I think this morning has been evidence that we've shown you quite a lot of other things.
Love the rugby, but it's a shame we had no reporters on the spot for the rowing world champs. Actually, one news we did, we had Andrew Potter, he's been filing a few stories on that, and it was fantastic vision, and he had a lovely
interview.
We had
very, very fulsome coverage of the rowing, actually. Are we obsessed with rowing in this country? Right, okay, is that your lot?
We're obsessed with doing well.
Okay, there's just this one here. Hi there, just got word that Dad was disappointed that I didn't call him on Father's Day. Sorry, I was a bit slow off the mark this morning. Please wish him happy Father's Day from me and tell him I'll call him tonight. That's Nicholas. Yeah, it's nearly 2 days later, of course. It is nearly 2 days later, isn't it?
That was nice of Nicholas.
Nicholas, yeah. I mean, he needed a bit of a buck up, didn't he, to remember, but...
It's probably actually... Well, it's not Father's Day in England, though, at the moment, is it?
We should frame this, shouldn't we? It's obviously all he's ever going to get from his children. We should frame that. It's a bit scraggly.
I know, we couldn't even print it off right, and look, it's sort of been caught around the edges as well.
Yeah.
But still, it's like, we'll pop that over for you.
Thank you.
Nicholas still loves you.
All right, Squawkers McCaw. As you know, we haven't got the parrot here because they're being boxed up beautifully to be sent off to 10 lucky winners.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we have been strict. You had to say the name of the parrot, right? And it's not going to win you the competition to send in a parrot picture. I mean, it's clever, but that won't win it. Put stickers all over your envelope. All these ones are ones that got it wrong. I know, they all got it wrong here. The correct answer was Squawkers McCaw. And we got some doozies, like, for instance, Mr. McCawber.
So even if someone said, like this one said, Squawker McCaw, because that looks like my grandmother's handwriting.
Well, she's dead. Anyway, no, quite frankly, one little thing wrong. Just one...
We are tough.
As luck would have it... Right, as luck would have it, we do have this many people who got it right.
Okay, let's clear some space.
So this is what happens, you see, if you don't get it right.
Oh, you have to listen carefully.
Oh, yeah, you've got to look at that. All right.
Can we get Rebecca now, declutter it?
We don't do the cleaning up here, as you can see.
Oh, okay. Right. There's not many here that got it right, is there?
No, I know. Isn't it incredible?
Okay.
So these are the winners'
piles. Nearly all of these people will win. Are we reading them out now?
Let's get someone over to draw it out. Malcolm, come over here, Malcolm. We'll get our cameraman over here. He's particularly ugly.
We give him so much grief.
He's a particularly ugly man.
He's a very talented man.
Come on over here, Melky. Now, you've got to close your eyes, right?
Yep.
I meant before you stepped on the set. I was looking forward to a trip over. All right, then.
Squish it all up.
Now, you close your eyes and you need to choose 10.
And don't move too much because no one's on the cameras now.
Yeah. No. That's right. You're completely out of focus,
one.
Malcolm.
Oh, that's a big one. That was always going to get picked, wasn't it?
All right. Okay. So, quickly, Malcolm, we don't want to be here all day. 3, 4, 5. Grub around in the bottom.
Yeah.
Oh, I knew this was going to take a while. It's the trouble you give away 10 parrots.
Okay.
You get a cameraman over to do it. Oh, oh, oh.
Oh, they look like they're the same. Oh, we better check on
right.
that.
Right, how many have you got?
I've got only one more. One, two, three, four.
You need one more.
Oh, yeah, the yellow one. Yeah.
And I need two more. Because it's five each.
Yeah,
have you got five?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay,
yeah.
I've got three.
Okay, I'm going to start reading them.
Yep.
Congratulations, Mrs. Ruth Sutton from Papakura.
Wow, that's a good one. Thank you, Malcolm.
Gail Greentree from Wairarapa. Well done.
Gail Greentree.
D and C Brown from Glen Massey, Narawahia. Well done. Bianca Prendergast from North Canterbury. And Michaela Rushton from Northcote.
Fantastic, you guys. And the others go to Warren Johns from Auckland. Remuera can afford to buy his own parrot. From Hornby in Christchurch, it's Wendy Chalmers. Then we've got Lebon...
Balumba.
Balumba.
Oh, that's exotic.
Yes, it is exotic. From Hamilton.
Balumba.
Balumba. It might not be pronounced that way. Lorraine Cole from Upper Hutt. And finally, W. Plowman from Botany in Auckland.
Wonderful.
Congratulations. We will have a Squawkers McCaw sent
on
out
to
you.
On his way. And hopefully old Squawkers will have an instruction manual, because we couldn't figure out how to work it.
It comes with a biscuit and everything. But thank you very much for entering. We had some fantastic entries and very colourful envelopes, as you can see. Coming up next on Breakfast, getting Kiwi bookworms to dollars. You want to grab one of these for the whole family. Well, that's it for Breakfast today. Coming up tomorrow morning on the program, amongst much else, Tim Wilson will take a look at the week in the United States.
And congratulations to our 10 winners of Squawkers here. I'm actually getting quite fond of the little guy.
Yeah, and you hated it to start with. 10 of them going out today. Hey, have a brilliant day today. We'll catch you back on Breakfast tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock.
See you then.